in which you are required to get the value of EF and BC. When you want to get the values of these sides, then you have to apply the congruency theorem. Sorry, similarity theorem. You have similarity. So, similarity theorem you have to apply. So, for that, if you wish, then you can apply in all the questions the similarity condition. The corresponding part of triangle AEF is the one triangle, ABC is the other triangle. They are parallel, so we have alternate angles equal and A is the common angle in these two triangles. So they are similar. If they are similar, then the ratio of their corresponding side is also equal. So we can say that AE upon if triangle AEF similar triangle ABC, then we can write AE by AB A upon
AC
is equals to
EF upon
BC. This condition we can apply. So let's begin the exercise. We have first question in which a triangle is given ABC
second part
you have to get DE. How can we get DE? its other part can you solve?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, the question number second, also the figure is given?
Yes, ma'am.
I am going to explain the third one.
Question number three. Question number 3, what is given?
In third question it is given that E and F are the points on the side PQ and PR respectively of a triangle PQR. You have triangle
PQ and R.
What are the points on the side PQ and PR?
PQE and PR and EF.
What are the points?
E and
F are the points on the side PQ and PR. Next, for each of the following cases, state whether EF parallel QR. The first is
D parallel AC.
This is
D.
and
V is given.
CL and
V is given.
You have to get the length of CL.
Yes.
Length of BE is
4 cm.
Only B is given.
EC is 2 cm.
BE is 4 cm.
EC is 2 cm.
EC is 2 cm.
Put the values
in place of BE.
Four.
BE is